When people want to disturb that peace, that's when he gets involved. His name is Joe Sapp. He's the peace officer, and he wears a star.
Take your man, rookie. They're sure taking a long time getting here, boss. Do you really think they're coming?
Well, they're coming, Rookie. A band of merry gentlemen is on their way here, disturbing the peace. I say just take them out.
Boss, I hear something.
So the angel says, do not be afraid.
Write that down.
You hear that? They're talking about angels, like the shepherds. I think we've had enough. Let's haul them in.
Wait!
You're under arrest!
You almost scared me to death!
You're not shepherds!
An amazing observation by the police.
Who are you? Who are you? What are you two doing?
My name's Scoop. I'm a reporter for the Bethlehem Examiner, and this is my co-reporter, Kel.
Newspaper reporters?
Nothing gets by you coppers. I'm simply stunned.
I'm Sergeant Joe Savage. This is my rookie patrolman, Patrolman Rookie. We're here to keep the peace. We just learned that a mob of shepherds are on their way into town.
That's old news, Sergeant. We've been on the story for an hour.
Well, they're gonna be surprised when they get into town.
You think you can stop them?
I know I can. You see this star? It means some sign of authority. Do you have a star?
No, I guess I don't, but this could be the biggest story of my career.
A bunch of shepherds is a big story?
You think this is about shepherds? They're saying that a baby born right here tonight could be a baby king.
You know, as in the long-awaited Messiah, the future king of Judah?
Judah already has a king, Herod, and only Cardass should have more than one king.
But Joe, if what they're saying is true, then a baby born right here tonight is the savior of the world. That's the biggest story in history.
The Savior of
Whoa, they're tiny. I always thought shepherds were bigger.
Yeah.
disturbing the whole town. Tell you what, when we finally arrest these married gentlemen, I'm going to make an example of them.
Hey, somebody, we've got to hear this.
Hey, who are you?
And what's the rush?
Name's Evie. I'm a big rig driver.
Big rig?
10-4. I haul freight. Say my camel, Diesel.
Your camel runs on diesel?
No, his name's Diesel. We had a caravan of big rigs inbound from Baghdad to Jerusalem. I was hauling figs.
See you driving off?
Please don't say it, Rookie.
A big fig rig. Sorry, I can't help myself.
We had the hammer down. We needed to get into J-Town by dawn. But my rig broke. It blew out a hoof. I tried to make it to Bethlehem. Heard there's a whole camel out there. But I didn't make it, so I looked into an oasis, and there they were. They were going on their way to Bethlehem.
I know. Shepherds.
Shepherds? What shepherds?
Not shepherds?
You got a copy on me at all, son? I don't know what shepherds you're talking about.
Then who's coming?
Wise men.
Wise men?
Wise guys?
Wise men. Magi.
Magi?
Magi are wise men from countries east of here. They're well educated and know the scriptures. Well, apparently they believe some king's been born somewhere around here, and they're on their way to give him gifts and worship him.
Where are they?
They're a long ways off. Days. Weeks. They don't even know where he was born.
Then how do we know they're coming here?
They're following a star, and the star's coming this way, night by night. But that's the problem, they can only travel by night.
So they're following a star. Okay, now I've heard it all. You had me scared there for a minute.
You don't believe in the star?
You think that driver's story is believable? Oh, the only star I believe in is this one right here.
But boss, they're coming!
You think that driver's story is believable?
Semi. Boss, this isn't like you. Why don't you believe in Magi?
You don't think I know what Magi are? They're smart men, obviously working for the Orient. They're up to no good. Wait, I've got it. You know where they're going?
No.
They're on their way to rendezvous with these Magi gentlemen. We gotta head them off before they get there.
Thank you.
isn't lost, how about everyone else? Frank?
Here.
Vince?
Yo.
Mer?
Present.
Okay, so at least we have Frank and Vince and Mer.
You know, I don't mean to tell the angels how to do their job or anything, but you think they could have mentioned which manger we'd find them in?
Yeah, how many more mangers can there be in this town?
I don't care if there's 1,000. I'm not going to stop until I find them.
Why do you think God told us first?
Yeah, why us? If God is sending the world a king, why us?
Well, remember what the angel said. Good news is great joy, which will be for all the people. Maybe saying that the shepherds are just as important as kings.
I know I'll never forget what I saw.
How did you see anything? You were so scared, you were hiding your face.
I was not. I was bowing down.
And shaking.
I was fearless. There's one thing you don't need to worry about, and that's me worrying. I have nerves of steel.
Still working. working on your big story?
Yeah, the baby who's going to be king, the Messiah.
Don't you get it? These shepherds are part of a plot. There's the baby story is just a cover. There's no baby, there's no angel, there's no star, and there's no king. Here, let me show you. Here's the shepherds, here's the angels.
The circle is the shepherds?
No, the X is the shepherds, the circle is the angels.
The rock is the manger, right?
Yes.
What's the net supposed to be?
No, it's just under the rock. This isn't working. Follow me. First, we have the shepherds. You guys be the shepherds.
Okay.
Okay, you guys stay here. Then we have an angel. Hey, what's your name?
Gabriel.
You be the angel. What's supposed to happen next?
The glory of the Lord shone around them.
Wow. Thanks, Gabriel. Then we're supposed to be looking for some manger? Okay, let's say this is our manger.
Just for argument's sake.
We'll just imagine.
And in this manger, there's this little baby in this tiny town in this big world. Can I use your baby for a second? We need to pretend that he's the Messiah.
What about the Messiah's parents?
Okay, you two be them. You come right here, and you come right here. Don't you see how this just simply couldn't happen?
It looks like it just did.
Isn't that just like God? We've been searching for him all night, and right when we were about to give up, we realized that the answer was in front of our faces the whole time.
Do you think God really did send a king, a Messiah?
All the evidence seems to say he did.
I don't know. I'm just not sure.
Wow, it's the star that the wise men are following.
Wow, there really is a star.
What did you say the star was?
The sign of authority. A sign of who's in charge.
Peace is here for you. He's the way.
You guys. Making noise, waking people up, and being outrageously happy without a license. You.
Wait, let me guess. Okay. Writing a story without authorization. I'm sure my pencil made squeaking marks that disturbed the peace, and I helped the shepherds get their story out.
I rustled a lot of papers and maybe spoke too loud. My hair made noise when I combed it, maybe?
Exactly. And you.
Joe, you gotta give these people a break. Sure thing you said the city of Bethlehem, but look at all the change in the world. You said it yourself, you just want Bethlehem to be peaceful.
And the rest of you.
Peering after dark?
Singing without a license?
Unauthorized worship?
Yes, yes, and yes. All my years, I've never seen anything like this. All right, Rookie, take a message to headquarters. Signed, Joe Sabbath. I am with the shepherds who have caused this alleged disturbance. I have found the baby that has caused this alleged disturbance. And after thorough investigation, I have found that peace has come to Bethlehem tonight. Signed, Joe Sabbath. May not be the quietest place on earth, but it is the most peaceful.
Yay!
Hey, I'll surely get off the fence or stop. You gotta get the news out.
For once, we have good news.
What are you guys staring at? Don't you have to get the word out?
Yeah,
come on.
Hold on. Me and Rook want to come with you.
Yeah!
Yeah.
turns out the tip was right. Something big happened in Bethlehem night, and our peaceful little town was never quite the same. Turns out that little baby was the Savior we've been waiting for, God's own son. He grew up strong and wise, but he never crowned king in Jerusalem. In fact, he was arrested and tried and crucified alongside real criminals. Even though his only crimes were healing the sick and blind and teaching us about his father's kingdom, an innocent man took the penalty for all of us. Wish I could say that I solved the case as soon as we found the baby king in the manger, but I could only see the part of the story that night. All those years later, then Jesus rose up out of the grave. That's when the case ran himself for us. What are you waiting for? Don't make me take you in on the 577342A. Failure to share the best news ever. Get out there and do it.
Would you get it up for all?